It's me.
The God Puppy.
We're back. It's the Mafia. This is my old man Italian voice.
We're back. Oh my God. We're cooked. We're absolutely juicing. Oh my God. We got it working. I played a little bit. We got it locked down. And I'm freaking ready.
The God Papi.
Now I did play a little bit already. I played like the first three missions because I actually thought I was just going to be recording this offline, but it worked so well. It's so juicy that I said, we play it on stream. We do the damn thing. Bah! So without craziness, without spiciness, and without further ado, we're on Mafia, the definitive edition. And I've never played Mafia before. I've seen them back in the days of demos on Xbox 360 Arcade. You could play the demo of this. I believe Mafia 1. And there's a mission where you're running through a building and then you run outside to a bunch of crates and you get into a huge firefight. And I know that that's in this game. Outside of that, zero knowledge. And of course the intro to the game, which I already knew because I bought this game a year ago. It didn't work and I sold it and I refunded. So now we're back. Shout out Game Pass, not even sponsored, but this is added on there. And I said,
we're doing it again.
We're on the damn thing. So, story, new game. For players looking for a classic challenge, enemies are lethal. Police respond to more crimes, fewer UI indicators, ammunition left in clip is lost when reloading. Enemies are more dangerous, police respond to more crimes, fewer UI indicators. We're gonna go hard here, and oh yeah, we're starting the frickin' story. Let's do this thing. I mean, you look at this and you almost go, how could there be a mafia? Andrew Bongiorno as Tommy. Jeremy Lucas Paulie. Don DiPetta. DiPetta? 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 I think it's DiPetta. Glenn Taranto. Taranto. Taranto? Taranto. Taranto. I'm thinking Tarantino, Taranto.
A crate over there.
Yeah, I was giving a casual. It looks good. who's our guy we're supposed to be looking at. It's gotta be this guy in the blue tie, right?
Tommy?
Thomas Angelo.
Detective Narman.
You alone?
No self-respecting bad just coming in here unless it's the health inspector.
What can I get you?
Just a coffee. Thanks. Dip your beak.
No, thanks.
Suit yourself. So, yeah. Said on the phone you might have a proposition for me.
That's right.
Well, if you're looking to set up a gravy train, you called the wrong cop. I'm not looking for any associates.
Good. Because I'm on the nut. Can't even pay for the coffee. But I got plenty to trade.
Let's hear it.
How long you been in town?
3 years. Caught my teeth in Empire Bay.
Well, they handed you the Morello case. Right out of the gate.
That's what the paper says, ain't it? And what's it to you?
Tough break. The case must be getting pretty cold by now.
Or you got something might warm it up?
Yeah. I might have something.
And what's my end of the deal? You want money? Some sort of immunity?
None of that. I got people I need to protect.
Ah, families. Always the Achilles heel, ain't it? So who you got? A sick ma or a wife and a litter of kids?
Wife and daughter.
No one else to watch your back, I'm guessing.
Wouldn't be here otherwise.
Pity that. Pa always said a man needs friends if he's going to survive in this world.
Yeah. Well, in my world, it's the other way around.
Okay.
No surprise there. Look, I can't promise anything for your family, not until I hear what you're trading. So, are you talking? Or are you just killing time before they come for you?
You think I'm on the run?
Oh, I know it, Tommy. Jesus, look at you. Surely gassed. You haven't slept for days. And your neck's got to be aching from all that looking over your shoulder you're doing. No, the way I figure it is you got someone powerful mean on your tail and they ain't giving up until you end up in the river. And you walk out that door without me, we both know you're not making it 5 steps. But, yeah, you stick around, you tell me your story, and maybe you got a shot at living long enough to walk that girl of yours down the aisle. Either way, looks like I'm buying you a cup of coffee.
Christ, I don't know how everything got so balled up.
No one ever sees the hairpin until it's too late. But you didn't get handed a heater in the nursery, did you?
No. I was a cab driver back in 30.
An offer you can refuse. Okay, okay. So our boy's out the door. Well, we're getting the OG start doing.
I mostly drove nights, because the money was better. It was at the end of one of those shifts, when I first met Polly and Sam.
Shit!
Cooking.
I got a gun pointed at you. They catch up, we're dead. But you don't get to walk away.
Hey, we don't got a shoe. We don't got a shoe.
Well, you got trouble. Drive. How the hell they know we'd be there? It doesn't matter now. We just gotta lose them.
How many cars we got following?
One for now. But there'll be more.
Hold tight. I'm gonna try something.
Yeah, get smoked.
Who were those guys?
You don't get
Would these cars
questions.
Explode like
we need
that?
To get over the river. Take the Giuliani Bridge.
Oh, okay.
Your leg okay up there?
Hurts like hell.
When we're back, I'll wake up the doc.
I don't know. It might be okay.
Just getting the call anyways. Hey, I see you listening, cabbie. You don't get to listen either.
All I'm doing is taking you guys where you want to go.
So do that.
Okay, we're at the river. Where am I taking you once we're over the bridge?
I'm getting tired out of questions.
I'm just trying to figure out where to take you, boss.
More of them.
Ah, shit.
Oh, mama. Well, that's perfect.
I know some shortcuts that'll slow them down.
Come on.
I don't care how you do it. Shake them off.
We just killed a guy.
That was your shortcut?
I lost him, didn't I?
Not all of them!
These guys really don't like it, do they?
Sometimes business partners fall out. It happens. Quit yapping, Polly. The more he knows, more chance of him not seeing the sun come up.
I would like to see the sun come up, please. Smoked.
You left them in the dirt.
We ain't clear yet. Keep driving.
Poor bastards digging the road for the works program aren't gonna thank us for this.
Three crates down. How many motors were at the exchange?
Four, five maybe.
Oh my god!
Sure feels like it. Next time we take more muscle.
You're expecting trouble.
Move!
If the boss hears about this, there'll be hell to pay.
My taxi's getting torched. It looks so beautiful.
They must have sent word out. There's more and more of them. We're not gonna last long unless we're back on our own turf. Let's get back to the neighborhood.
Smoked. Smoked. Oh, we gotta back up anyways. Who's this guy?
West Harbor Bridge, cabbie, fast!
Yeah, buddy, I'm dying! Oh my god. Oh my god. Buddy, how many rounds do you have in that revolver? You just shot a civilian.
The bridge is up, ain't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We can make it.
What the hell are we doing?
Just sit tight and pray.
Never done that before. Me neither.
Okay, so little. Now, your night's not over.
Unfortunately.
I didn't see this coming. You think he squealed?
I think you zip it tight. We talk it through back at the bar.
Who squealed? Let me know.
Okay, we're close.
A little over in front of that bar.
Salieri's place.
Yeah, that's the one. Wait here.
What for?
You want a little something from the Don or not?
Ah.
Hey, whoa, Fedora guys, don't be looking at me now. Oh my.
Compensation for your services. Any damage to your car. This makes us square.
Okay.
I'm sure it's more than enough.
Good. Don Salieri wants you to know that he's very grateful. So if you ever need anything, maybe a loan or some honest work, don't hesitate to ask. Don doesn't forget his friends.
Yeah, okay, thanks.
One more thing. This matter stays between us. Anyone asks where you got that money, you want it at poker. The scratches on your car, you swerved to keep from hitting a little old lady.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that tracks. Mm-hmm.
Of course.
See you around, kid.
The car's still running and not, like, leaking any fluids is kind of crazy.
When I opened the envelope, I could have had a heart attack. Enough to fix the cap. Nearly enough to buy a new one. I thought about what Sam said about work. I wasn't interested. The money was good, sure, but I didn't want to get in with criminals. Better to be poor and alive than rich and dead. So, right there, back then, I was out.
So it's already getting spicy, and I'm definitely not familiar with this type of, so like we're going in and we're like getting the ending of the game, like with the guy going in and trying to get help, but we're obviously now going through the very beginning of it. So it's cool. I like it. What's next? Running Man. Okay.
After that night with Salieri's guys, I was back working as soon as I could. But it felt different. You get a lot of time with your thoughts when you're a cabbie.
Okay.
And other people's thoughts, too.
You there, driver?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you driving or loitering?
Driving, ma'am. Always driving. So where to?
St. Michael's Church, directly.
Okay.
Keep on tasting better and better.
Long careful, please.
I always drive careful.
Then you'd be the first.
What is the cop doing?
A strong cigarette. A strong man smokes Big Break Red.
Oh, let's not hit the cop car.
Turn that racket off. I can't hear myself think. That's much better.
So, church. It's Sunday already.
Eyes on the road, please.
Does this lady not talk to us a whole lot? What's going on, lady? Why don't you like us?
St. Michael's. That'll be 30 cents.
The only tip I'll give you is to stop smoking in your vehicle. I felt like I was sitting in an ashtray.
Sure. Whatever you say.
These Italians are all the same.
What the fuck?
Can't drive without the radio. Better find a new fare.
Art gallery. Get me there quick.
Sure. Quick I can do. Taking some time out.
What's it to you?
Not much. Just talking.
I'm paying you to drive, so do that. Look at him out there. The problem with this downturn is that it's made people lazy. Giving them an excuse.
The work's not out there, pal.
The work is always there. You just have to find it.
I get it. You're a busy guy. I don't see so many these days.
I saw this crapshoot depression coming. Saw that before the crash. So yeah, I get to be busy.
Your busy day's gonna be looking at old paintings?
I have a business meeting there with a colleague. Not that it's anything to do with you. If you ever find a real job, then maybe you'll understand. Until then, drive and quit bothering me.
Okay.
Yeah, I get you.
What is this radio station?
David, see?
Move, lady! God!
Pull up in front of the gallery.
You're lucky I'm not a mafioso yet.
Thanks, pal. Here's 50 cents. I'll spend it all at once.
I'll try not to. Every fair today's been a son of a bitch. On to the next.
Hey, over here.
Who's this guy?
Like shit.
I've been working since 5. What's your excuse?
Booze.
Figures. Where are we going?
Little Italy, 21st Street.
Okay. If I don't tell the cops about the liquor on your breath.
Jesus, that one hurt.
That one did hurt.
Okay. If I don't tell the cops about the liquor on your breath, you don't tell them when I break the limit. Good deal.
Great deal. Got any good fares today?
Yeah, some. But never enough of them.
Who's got the money for cab rides since the market tanked and all went to shit, I guess? Only reason I got you taking me places is I'm drunk and don't know better.
Okay. Respectable mafioso.
Don't see enough drunk fellas. They're only after the people moving it and selling it.
Yeah, but I've seen them go after guys for less.
Guess so. If they think they can shake something out of you, they will use any excuse. This city's corrupt as all hell.
Sure is.
On the corner, please. Hey, my cousin has a coffee stand around the corner. Tell him Lucio sent you. Take a break, huh?
Thanks. Might just do that.
Well, thanks, Lucio. Lucio. Oh, appreciate you, Lucio. Oh.
Hey, how you doing, pal? You remember me? Yeah? Huh? Mr. Morello's a little bent. Shouldn't go helping Salieri's goons, huh? I'm gonna have to give you a beating. Just so you always remember who runs this town. Make it so you won't do much rocking for a while, eh? Look at this guy. I didn't think he'd make it fun. Let's get him.
Oh my god!
As fast as you can! All we want to do is talk,
Captain! Oh! Oh! Come on, keep going! Oh my god, come on. You guys are too slow. Too slow. Too slow. You're too slow.
Look at this.
How you doing, kid? Dino, Lou. You got business with the Don?
Nah, we're just trying to talk to that cabbie over there, that's all.
That right?
Yeah.
Well, this here's the Don's favorite driver. So anything you got to say to him, you can say to me.
Is that right? Well, I'll tell you something, pal. We ain't leaving empty-handed, that's for sure.
Well, then maybe you ain't leaving at all.
Woo-hoo-hoo! Okay, then. See your boys around. Let's go, Lou.
Hey, thanks. Least we could do.
Come on. Let's go say hi to the Don.
Don Salieri? Yeah. He's gonna want to hear about this.
That's crazy. Okay, so this is our intro because we were getting beat up by these dudes. Now we kind of have to go to them. All right.
What do they call you, son?
Thomas. Thomas Angelo, sir.
Frank told me you ran into some trouble?
Yes, sir. My cab got smashed up pretty good.
Morello's thugs went after him by the kind of Tommy helping us.
This, taxi, that's your livelihood?
Yes, sir.
I feel a sense of responsibility here. So I'm gonna set you up with a small loan, enough to get that cab of yours fixed up.
Well, I appreciate that, sir, but I'm not looking for a handout.
Then what are we doing here?
I just want a shot at the bastards who wrecked my cab.
You hear that, Frank? The kid wants my permission to get into a fight.
Yes, I heard.
Okay, Tommy Angelo. All the Morello's grills hang out at a bar he owns. Paul, you know the place.
Sure do, boss.
Good. You can ride along with Tommy. There's a lot right next to the bar where they park their cars.
Okay.
Smash up a few tin cans, send Morello a message.
All right.
He can't rough up hardworking Joes in my neighborhood without getting a black eye.
Thank you, Mr. Salieri. I won't let you down.
I almost kind of feel like...
And Tommy, when you get back, We'll talk about what's next for you.
All right. I kind of get a vibe from this guy that, like, I don't know.
No one else knows you here, so tread careful, okay?
Sure.
I kind of feel like, you know, me saying I'm not going to let you down. I'm going to go do this thing for you. Don't worry about it. I got you. To the Don, he's just like, I appreciate you.
Who's the new
Although that's exactly what he wants.
Cabby, we're helping him out.
He's going to drive the boss?
Nah, you don't lose your job that easy.
I hate sitting around. Boring as hell.
If the boss says you're not ready to come out on collections, what can you do?
Don Salieri, I'm writing to let you know of my joy to hear that you will be attending the wedding of my daughter. Please, if there are any further arrangements you would wish for, let me know. It will be a wonderful day, and for the world to see that the occasion has your blessing, you will make it even more special and memorable. Your loyal friend, Giovanni Romano.
I don't get what his problem is with
Find
Polly.
Anything good?
What do you think I gotta do?
Yeah,
now?
I think you should've I'm watching you. Carlo. Got it?
Gonna give a good
I
answer.
Get it.
Prohibition here to stay. Production and sale of alcohol to remain illegal. In a speech to gathered press, President Herbert Hoover reiterated today that the noble experiment of prohibition will remain in place. Forced to respond to Democrat criticism, Hoover also promised a more efficient and better funded prohibition bureau to prevent profiteering and smuggling.
As high a value as was recorded during the Depression of 1921.
Gracias, recorde. Sí.
Cigarette card, okay, very cool.
The bars are closed for you, I'm afraid. Come back later with Paulie or Sam.
Okay.
Anyways, I got places to be. Okay, come through this way.
Okay, let's do this thing.
Give Vinny first. He's a loudmouth, but Frank and Adon have known him since forever.
What's he do?
We go see him whenever we need to do any heavy lifting. We make sure
heavy
we're
lifting, huh?
But we gotta go. Long drive back north. If the Don wants to do this again, we can meet him.
Buongiorno, Vincenzo.
Buongiorno.
Oh, Polly. Oh, she's gonna sing. Who's this then?
Vinny. This here's Tommy Angelo. We're doing a little job together.
All right. Good, good.
Hey.
You just need bean shooters or ruts?
Nah, we just need something to write off a few cars.
Huh. Oh, I got just the thing.
This classic should do the trick. Oh! If the bat don't work out for you, I got a few cocktails here.
Ay, ay, ay.
Careful with them, though. Don't want to burn off your short ears. Good to meet you, Todd. Let me know if Paulie gives you the hard time.
Okay.
I'll straighten him out.
Ralphie's in the garage. He's a special kind of idiot, but he's got away with cars. I don't get how this moron gets engines to burn. But I'm telling you, it's like some kind of black magic.
Well, how's he stupid?
Hey, genius!
Get your head out of your ass!
This guy.
What the fuck, dear Polly? You can't just sneak up on a guy like that.
I'm sorry, Ralphie. I'm just busting your balls.
See, you're still a little limping. Guess we got two cripples working here.
We ain't nothing alike. You got that, Ralph?
Sure, Papa Polly. Yeah.
Tommy Angelo.
Good to meet you.
Like I said, Ralphie here's a cracked egg. Well, you bring him a stolen car, he'll make it yours. Tom and me, we got a job to do. We need some wheels.
How about this one, Polly? It ain't a hot rod, but it'll get you across the town.
All right, let's go. You're driving.
Okay.
And don't let me catch you loafing off again.
One day I'm gonna cut your brake line, asshole.
I don't know what Ralph's trying to pull giving us this motor. I want to show you something about the good life, and you're driving something my mom could have bought 20 years ago. If I know Ralph, he probably got it taken out of our yard.
Yeah, the car's fine. It's good to get a change from the cab.
You don't have to be nice about it. This thing's a tin can.
So, was that whiskey back there in the truck?
Yep. New supplier.
You guys...
Hey, it's their cars we're wrecking today, not this junker.
You guys deal in broad daylight?
Normally, we got cops. Either lose them or pay the fine, I guess.
Don't move.
They're still on us.
I need you to get out of the car.
I thought I could pay.
You in.
Did I not
Stay
pay?
Still.
Can I not pay the fine?
Lose the cops!
How do we? They said pay the fine. What the? It said stop and pay the fine. Is that not how you stop and pay the fine? I guess he just literally means pay the fine by doing the time. I guess that's probably what he means.
I don't know what Ralph's trying to pull giving us this motor. I want to show you something about the good life, and you're driving something my mom could have bought 20 years ago.
My mom.
I know Ralph, he probably got it taken out of our yard.
Hey, the car's fine. It's good to get a change from the cab.
You don't have to be nice about it.
Come on, copper.
So, was that whiskey back there in the truck?
Yep. New supplier. Hey, it's there. We got cops.
Oh,
either lose them or pay the
fine. Dang
it.
Are we gonna lose him in this thing?
Okay, arrest the guy. Officer,
drive safe. They're still looking for us.
Like a glove. Oh, we couldn't have done it better. Smooth operator in this tiny little thing. Surprised this thing gets up the hill. Oh man, okay, come on.
All officers, search is called up.
Yeah.
New supplier.
You guys deal in broad daylight?
Normally, nah. This was their first drop-off, and the cops know better than to come sniffing around our turf. Morello, the guy whose cars you got a torch, he's got more friends in the forest than us. But we're okay, as long as we're careful. Keep an eye over our shoulder. Some of the Canadian whiskey that comes through,
okay.
You want a bottle? Just ask. We'll keep some back for friends.
I'm no big drinker. I used to tip back bathtub gin most days, but not so much now. That stuff's no good for you.
You don't have to go blind now, though. To us, you got a line on the good stuff.
That's good of you. Thanks.
Not just the booze we supply, Tom. It's the places we deliver to. The dames they got in these places. Best tables, best food, best skirt. Some way to live.
Right now, all I want to do is wreck the day of the bastards who wrecked mine.
Sure.
Besides, all this could get a guy in trouble.
Trouble says the guy is about to set fire to Morello's parking lot.
I love this guy's voice.
It'll go fine.
Okay, it's close by. Well, if it don't go fine, try not to let him see your face. Either that, or you hit him so hard they don't remember it. Morello's goons smoke and jaw up front and leave their motors out back.
Okay.
They're some lazy bastards. They put some gorilla on guard duty, but it's always some no-name schmuck. Come on, over here. You gotta sneak in and wreck the cars.
Is this guy walking with us or are you?
Sure. Why are you coming with?
To see if you get shot.
boss and send us out on what jobs?
Nah, he's got his main guys. He'll get there someday.
What the?
City real pissed. Thanks and careful.
As long as I get the money on
time. Hey! What the hell you doing?
What do you mean, what am I doing?
I mean what I say. What the hell are you doing back there?
Who are you?
A guy who don't know what idiot told you to keep lookout.
Smoked!
You got it. Now let's get to these cars. Take your bat and start swinging.
Oh. Me Bombo, what are you doing?
That motor really got you pissed, huh?
I like, the aiming is terrible.
Oh, crap.
Hey, get away from the car. Come
now
get
down, Tom!
Oh.
Got some kind of death wish?
Hmm? Son of a!
Just like that. Come on, quick. There's gotta be more of them. Use a Molotov and let's see some flames.
Wow.
Yeah, you got that nice and good.
Are they gonna blow up? Oh.
Whole block heard that.
Oh.
We gotta go. We can take Dino's car.
How'd you know this is Dino's car?
I don't like you, and you got a good car.
Are these type of cars, like, capable of exploding that crazy big? Probably, right?
It's right near Morello's place. Don't bring in the wrong people.
Don't bring in the wrong people.
Straight through the gate. We gotta get out of here before the bulls show.
Don't let him get away!
Was that guy asleep on the road?
Ah, shit. We got cops.
So, what do we do?
We lose them by driving real fast and getting clear of them.
Sounds good.
Right now they're pissed. But let's not get them real pissed.
What the fuck? Whoa. Come on!
What,
there's like 10...
The big house?
No! Smoked. Idiots.
Okay, we lost
absolute bozo
till they lose interest.
Get smoked. All right, let's get out of here.
Still looking for us.
All officers, search is called off. Repeat.
We're good. Let's head back and see the boss.
Okay.
I thought Silieri had cops on the books.
Some street cops, sure. But Morello's got the chief in his pocket.
He's got the chief in his pocket.
How'd it feel? Feel good?
How'd what feel?
Taking out the guy. Taking Dino's car. Feel good?
Yeah. I guess it did.
There's no time like the first time, Tom. Don't get better.
You think it's for you? This life?
What's it to you?
Hey, I'm just asking questions. I like asking questions.
I'm just asking
questions. Every day you and
I
Sam
like asking
go
questions.
Beat motors in parking lots.
What happened to the car I sent you out with?
Dumped it.
Why?
Dumped it.
It was a boiler. This one's better.
A better car with a broken window?
Fresh ain't never killed nobody.
Sorry, I forgot your name already.
He's still with you then?
Somehow, yeah.
Hey, boss. It's done.
No trouble?
Nothing we couldn't handle, Mr. Salieri.
Good, good. Sit down. You see Morello?
Nah. But he'll be plenty pissed when his boys tell him what happened.
He's not gonna be able to think straight for weeks. See, that's the difference between me and Morello. I'm a businessman. I do everything with this. Every decision I make, it's what's good for the business and my boys. But Morello is a hothead, and all that anger burns out the brain. And when he gets mad, he gets stupid.
You got nothing like that to worry about with Tommy here. He was aces the whole way, boss.
I'm glad to hear it.
Blowing review from Polly. Thank you, Polly.
We could use a guy like you to help out around the bar. Maybe run some errands, make sure the bills get paid on time. You up for that?
Oh, it'd be an honor, sir.
Good. Good. Now, Polly and Sam have already vouched for you, but you need to understand we have a few rules around here, so you listen and listen good.
Okay.
First, no cursing on the premises. There's a million words out there. And the man who needs to resort to fuck this and fuck that is just ignorant or lazy. Second, we don't deal in the hard stuff. I don't want any dope fiends in this neighborhood.
Okay.
We'll let Morella poison his own people if that's what he wants. Finally, stay out of trouble with the cops. We only have a few on the payroll. And if you cross the line, the rest will come after you. You understand?
Yes, Mr. Salieri.
Then I'm going to only ask you for one more thing, Tommy. I don't keep Paulie and Sam around just because they're strong. A lot of guys out there bigger and tougher than these two. And I don't keep Frank on the payroll because he's smart. Though he is an artist with the numbers. All these guys in this room, they're here because they have the only thing that matters to me. The only thing that should matter to any of us. You know what that is, Tommy?
They're loyal.
That's right.
Mm.
Now, you stay straight with me, you're going to be living the high life, Tom.
Mm.
But you abuse my trust.
Don Salieri, you won't ever need to worry about me.
Okay, then. Welcome to the family.
Hey!
Excellent. Now I'm starving. Luigi, let's eat.
Welcome. A barman Luigi is not much of a cook. But his daughter Sarah, Maron.
Maron! Nice! Very juicy, okay?
Those first days in Salieri's bar were slow. I moved crates and delivered messages. The guys busted balls and told stories from the old country. Mostly, we just waited. I got to thinking, maybe life in Salieri's crew wasn't gonna get me clipped.
Come on, I got
you. What did I know?
Finish it all. You, Tommy?
Come on, this
yeah.
In your tank.
Boss
get
is waiting for you.
Thanks.
Ignora quell'idiota. Arrenditi. Ah, potrei combattere ancora.
What's going on, boss?
Here he is.
Sorry I'm late.
Take a seat.
Siri, I'm late.
And it's collection day, boys. So, Tommy, you'll drive. Paulie and Sam can handle the rest. It'll be routine.
Just a handful of stops today.
Bill at the motel was a little short last month. So make sure he pays us the interest he owes.
No problem, boss.
Don't lay hands on anyone unless there's no other choice. Our clients need to understand that we provide a valuable service. They need to look at you and see Santa Michael.
Okay.
They need to believe you'll protect them.
So let Morella stoop to breaking legs. We're better than that. But the bills still do, and everyone pays up.
We can handle it.
Go see Ralphie about a car.
Okay, boss.
Oh, Vinny said to say he's got something for you, Tom. Head to him first. Probably just wants to tell you some bullshit story about some guy he whacked 20 years ago.
Okay.
Hey!
This is the guy.
I saw this, and I thought of you.
Ah! This little guy.
You ever carried a rat?
Shot him at the fair a couple of times.
Right. That don't count. Pointed at the target over there. Good bang. Brain off the walls. Okay? Now show me a reload.
Not at me, you moron.
I open the chamber and away you go. All right. Last thing. Needs to be hidden. Stick it in your belt.
I can't shoot in here.
Good to go. And when shooting starts, get behind something and don't shit yourself.
Thanks, Vincenzo. I appreciate it.
Hey, the Frank and the boss is Vincenzo. To you, it's Finny.
Look at that little violin gun he has right there. That's a Tommy gun that's just all pieced together. That's tight, okay? Cool. All right, let's get out of here. We got a little baby gun. What up, gentlemen?
You guys need to be careful today, okay? I spoke to Biff. He said Morello's still bent since he lost the cars.
What's losing some motors to him? He's got at least 5 garages this side of town.
He's not wrong, Polly.
You guys know it like I know. It's always the same. Morello does this, so Salieri does that. Some cars here, some...
Hey, what's up, guy?
You know how to get into one of these, Tommy?
Elbow goes through. Reach inside. Easy.
And in the afternoon to fix the window back up. Watch. And... learn.
You're a regular magician, Ralphie.
Come on, Tommy. Show me what you can do. Okay, it's car. I got it. Have a good day, fellas.
You too, Ralphie. Appreciate you, big pimp.
First, we got Al. He runs a bakery on Longman Street. You know it?
Yeah, I know it.
Al's late again? Seems so. That's too bad.
Oh, I love it. 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 I just love the look of it. It's just like, it's so built up and modern, but not. I love the cars too. And this is set in 1930, right? So like right after the crash. Nice, okay. I wish there was like a first person mode. This gotta honk every time you do anything. What's going on here?
Okay, this is it. Watch what we do today, Tom. When it goes smooth, it's a breeze. When they put up a fight, sometimes you gotta think on your feet.
Sure.
Just follow my lead.
Okay.
Sam, Polly, how are you?
We're good. How's little Julia?
Mr. Bertarelli, this letter is notification that you are default in of your obligation to make payments on your agreed loan. This amount has been overdue since July 15, 1930. You have ignored requests to pay this debt. Unless the full amount is received within 2 weeks, I will have no choice but to instruct this bank to begin foreclosure process on your home and business. Please act accordingly. Christopher Marcino, Manager, Grand Imperial Bank.
So little now, she's turning into a pain in the ass, just like her grandma.
That's good to hear, Al. Real good. Now, you got any trouble around here? Any punks causing problems?
No, no. Nothing like that.
Good. So you got the money?
I got it waiting in the back room. I'll...
Tommy will get it. You stay here where we can see you.
It's been real slow this month, Sam. I was worried I wouldn't have enough.
Al, I know you'd never hold out on us, but it's good you worried. I mean, how can we protect you and little Julia without payment?
You gonna take all day, Tommy? We got places
we need
to be.
Where's the money?
It's on the table, brown envelope.
Okay.
Via di qui. Lasciateci in pace.
I got it. We'll see you next month, Al. Let us know if you need anything. Anything at all.
Sure will, Sam. Sure will.
And give our best to your mom, huh?
Oh my gosh, he put his head down immediately. This dude does not at all want to even...
It was a real pleasure meeting you.
Okay, next up we got old Eugene's place.
Okay.
Chinese store up on Tallow.
He's not dead yet?
Almost. Heard his nephew's taking over.
He's guy used to run this next place, Tom. His name's not Eugene. Guy's a Chinaman. But it sounds like Eugene. Well, that's what we called him.
Polly slammed his head into the counter back in, what, 27, I think?
We got police coming!
Officers in Little Italy report that they've lost sight. If you see him, let me know. Yeah, he's been seen. Go get him, boys. Okay, arrest the guy.
Get these flatfoot bastards off our ass!
It's so funny getting into a car chase with these cars.
Officers in Little Italy reporting they've lost sight. If you see him, let me know.
What's up there?
Yeah, he's been seen. Go get him, boys. He's now moving through Chinatown.
Unemployment rises again.
Go, go, go! We're doing everything wrong! Smoked, idiots. Oh! Come on!
Shut up,
bitch. Ah! Watch out, sir! No! Why are you driving in front of me? Don't be a Samaritan! Ah! Okay, now we're back on the right path. God, the first thing they said was don't get any trouble with the cops, all right? What do? I go get in a bunch of trouble with the cops.
Looks like we lost them. Holly slammed his head into the counter back in, what, 27, I think? This is it.
I'll cover this one, Sam.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure.
Sure, I'm sure.
He's doing the store on his own?
Yeah, when Polly's built up a little steam, he needs to let it out on his own. She's gotta let him get on with it. It's his way. You can hear it in his voice. Gotta let him lone wolf from time to time. Keeps him happy. Yeah, Eugene's nephew ain't having much fun right now. When he's going, Polly don't stop. Once we were putting a squeeze on this tailor over in Holbrook, the guy ended up in a wheelchair.
I thought he said don't break legs, don't be like a bully to him.
Here he comes.
He's a fast worker.
Drive before the cop show, Tom. Next stop's Bill at the motel. Eugene's nephew's guy's money is ours next week, with some extra besides.
He doing okay?
He's okay.
How's the shop counter?
Yeah, that's seeing some more blood.
How much blood?
And nothing he can't scrub out. Once he's back on his feet.
So is he beating the shit out of the Chinese guy? The China rest, Chinatown guy?
Nephew guys scrubbing their
I don't know if that was a restaurant. Was it a restaurant or a shop?
Seems like it's not too hard.
Not hard. Kind of not hard.
I don't know. Comes natural to you guys. Don't see why it can't come natural to me.
So anyone could do this. Me and Polly, we've been working these streets for years. You come in and you think you know it all.
I'm not saying that, Sam.
You've been a day on the job, pal. You haven't seen what we do. You haven't seen how we do it.
Sam, I think you oughta...
No, Polly. This punk thinks he can walk in here like a big shot. I put greasers like him in the ground.
I think you gotta say you're sorry, Tom.
Sorry, huh? Well, I'd say sorry if I couldn't see the bullshit smile you're trying to hide.
You got him, though, Sam! You got him!
I could smell the crap in your pants from here.
Nah, you didn't get me.
When little Tony first came out with us, I had him on his knees before he knew I was yanking his chain.
Yeah, you did better than him anyways.
Okay. Look at this place. Wow.
Jesus. I hate it out of the city.
You hate it most places.
Yeah, but out here it's worse.
How come there's a place so far out of town on our books?
It's so beautiful.
Out of town's the safest place for deals. Safest place for card games. The safest place for most of the things we built.
We're expecting a big bag of money today. The guy owes. If it ain't big, boss will be pissed.
Yeah, this place is a real earner. Oftentimes, the places that get you the most dough are the ones most people don't look at twice.
Just recently, the motel's had a new lease of life.
Last stop before Lost Heaven for rum coming up from Cuba.
They drive it this far?
Sure they do. And that's how we can sell it so expensive.
Bill's motel has gotten to be the place where crates get exchanged. Salieri protects it, but he lets the other families use it, too.
Even Morello?
To keep the peace, Sure.
Plus, it's far enough away that no one cares.
So long as everyone's making money,
sure.
No one's gonna rock the boat.
Anyone else starting to miss the sight of streets and sidewalks?
You not one for the great outdoors, Polly?
He's not one for anything. Indoors, outdoors, in the city, out of the city.
I hate it out here. Like when we sit in the field doing some booze handover or something. It's always knee-deep in shit, and most times it's dark and cold as hell.
That's why it's good we got you now, Tom. You can do all the jobs that Polly hates.
But happy to oblige.
This is a crazy long drive, though. Like, realistically, this seems like an hour-plus type drive in real life. Like, if not in game terms.
Okay. There it is.
Finally.
That's a nice car right there.
Wait for us here, Tom. We'll be back in a bit.
Okay. Okay.
Tell Salieri from here on out this place is ours. Capiche? And don't come back, or you'll end up in worse shape than your friends.
Get Sam. They're trying to beat information out of him.
I gotta get you to a doctor.
I can wait. Get Sam out of there.
Okay, just hang on.
Can a guy take? What year is it? Ow! Ow! Oh my god! I forgot I did hard difficulty. We have not been in any combat yet. I completely forgot. One thing I'm gonna say, I'm putting bullets in all of them. Simple. Come on.
I know.
Why the hell didn't we just
over
run
here?
All out?
Morello says we don't know.
Beating on their guys and stuff.
Oh!
Guns. Out this! He's coming after me!
Ah! Oh, smoked. Smoked. Murked! How's it feel? Get smoked! Yeah, smoked all of your boys. Yeah, one more.
Sam. Whoa, they really went to work on you, buddy.
Christ.
Come on. You'll be all right. You're tough as nails.
He's got the money, Tom!
Oh, catch the bastard!
Where is Sam?
He's okay. Inside.
Then go get the money!
Come on! No health. How are we supposed to survive that?
But what do you mean?
Where is Sam?
He's okay. Inside.
Then go get the money.
We literally have no health. I'm just gonna, I guess, just pop off a million rounds, right? This is crazy. We gotta, like, we have to keep our distance, or else we're just not gonna be able to do it. What the? No, keep going. Get smoked, idiot. See you later. I believe the goons are probably supposed to make this a little bit of a harder drive. I just took like 7 shots.
When I saw the cost, what it meant to be on the inside. I should have took off there and then. But I couldn't go back to being a nobody.
Sheesh! Wow. That was crazy. Oh my god, that was crazy.
Intermezzo.
It's been 8 years.
So that's how a regular palooka goes from cabbie to mob enforcer overnight, is it? Just dumb luck?
Didn't feel that way at the time. Me parking on that particular street, taking a break just when Polly and Sam are coming around the corner, what are the odds? I felt like someone was watching out for us.
Whatever helps you sleep at night, pal, but it's a lucky break all the same. I mean, one day you're busting your back, doing an honest day's work in a city that's been trying to scrape you off its heels since the day you stepped off the boat, and the next you're stuffing your pockets full of Salieri's dirty money and lording it over the rest of us.
Yeah, it wasn't like that. Back then, Salieri didn't have the run of the city. For every buck Salieri made, Don Morello would turn 10. He paid off cops, politicians, judges, and anyone he couldn't buy, he scared into looking the other way.
He did seem to have the city jumping in its own shadow, I'll give you that.
You hear anything about Joey Crackers?
Yeah, got his name in the Morello file, sure. Boxer, right?
Yeah. That's the guy.
Yeah. That's the guy.
Way I hear it, Joey was just driving to the gym one morning. Probably daydreaming about winning a belt or something.
God damn it! Moron! You drive with your goddamn eyes closed! Look at this! Jesus, Mary, Joseph, Tom Morello, I didn't know it was you.
You know anybody else driving a rare import in this part of town, Joey?
No. Well, then, I'm sorry, I was driving real slow.
You're saying this is my fault?
No, sir. I ain't never been in no accident.
Well, repairs are gonna be expensive.
Oh, you're not gonna need that, sir. The tires are just fine. Grill's a little bent up, is all. I mean, I got a cousin again.
Someone spun you a tail, pal. You got an informant right there, says Morello made a mint every time Crackers went to the mat.
That's true, too. And still, Morello left that poor sap dead in the street, head all caved in.
That don't square.
Well, maybe the Don knew Joey's career was on the downhill. Well, maybe he was trying to scare some other guy into paying up. Who knows? Don Salieri chalked it up to Morello not being able to think straight when he was mad.
You have any more run-ins with Morello's crew back then?
Not at first. For a couple of years after I joined up, things were quiet. We got into a few dust-ups with guys trying to muscle in, but elsewise it was just the usual routine. We were running booze, offering protection, me and the boys doing rounds to collect, small time. But I ain't gonna lie. Most days, we was also having a bit of fun.
Okay.
Tommy, thanks for getting down here so quickly.
Yeah, sure thing, boss. What do you need?
You know, there's a race coming up.
Oh, yeah. Polly and Sam have some money on the local.
Mikey Dunn.
That's the guy.
He's a good kid, but a bit of a scrapper. Not too smart with his money. A few years ago, Mikey comes to me asking for a loan. He wants to get new tires so he can keep racing junkers out at the quarry. I like fast cars. I figured it'll be a bit of a hobby. Turns out, Mikey's a great investment. The kid can't lose a race if he walks the track. He graduates from the junkers to gouge jobs, and I start placing a few bets on him here and there. Next thing I know, I've made all my money back and more.
Hey, Sam says he's the guy to beat.
He was. We ran all the competition out of town. But now Ralph says there's a hotshot European entering the race. And he's got a car faster than our boys by a country mile.
How much do we stand to lose?
A truckload. But not just our outfit. A lot of guys from the neighborhood come to me for financial advice. They've all put money down on this kid. It'll be like Black Thursday around here if he loses. Well, for everyone except Morello.
Oh, you think he's from the European?
Oh, I'm certain of it.
You want something to happen to the driver?
Can't find him. Merle's got him holed up somewhere safe. Besides, if he drops out or disappears now, none of our wagers will stand. Everyone will cry foul, say the race is fixed.
What about his car?
That's the ticket, Tommy. Ralph knows a guard at the track. You go down there tonight, you boost the European's car, bring it to one of our mechanics, and make a few adjustments, you bring the car back.
Should be no problem, boss.
Sarah, can I get a drink here? As soon as you're ready.
Sure thing.
Your pop letting you out for the race?
You kidding? Feels like we're packing this place up and moving it to the stands.
Wow.
Buonasera, Tommy.
Buonasera, Tommy.
Hey, Titi Tommy. Big day coming up, right? You seen the race before?
Kind of hard to miss. Celieri isn't going to let Morello break his winning streak, huh?
No, sir. Gotta send him a message. So, tonight, we borrow his guy's motor from the track. My friend Bobby is a guard. For a little dough, he'll show you where it is, then look someplace else while you turn the key.
I like Bobby already.
Sure. Then there's this other guy, Lucas Bertone. You take the car to him down under the Giuliano Bridge. He'll, tune it a little. Make the race tomorrow more interesting.
Then I take the car straight back and Bobby can stop looking someplace else.
But you gotta be quick. Bobby comes off shift at 1:30 and then the next guy, he's an ass,
okay.
Oh, hey, if you need somewhere to keep your motor safe where no one can take them, feel free to use the garage. Carlo finally got around to clearing it out.
Thanks, good to know.
When did we get the V12? Copper. I don't know where we got this juicer of a car from. It is running really well, though. It looks awesome. It's running really good. I like. Not in the brand new V12.
Bobby. Yep. We can take your car to the garage. Place is empty.
Any friend of Ralphie's a friend of mine.
I mean, if you got the money, sure. Tomorrow morning they start coming. Whole city. They smuggle in hooch. There's fighting. I hate it.
Come on. Name a better place to pick up a day than this place this weekend.
Don't get me started. Things I've seen. Okay, this is it.
Oh, wow.
1929 Carrazella C Series. Best in class. It's a shame you gotta wreck it.
They see this down the road. Cops are gonna ask questions.
When they catch up, sure. Try to keep it in one piece, too, huh?
So, I gotta be back from Bertone by 1:30 before the next guy's shift.
Yeah, he's an ass.
I heard.
Oh, this thing's awesome. We're definitely crashing it though. Imagine all the people being woken up by this thing. It's already almost on fire. Let's get it back here in one piece. No problem, boss.
Something's up. You guys aren't gonna believe this, but we got a race car driving at speed. Okay, arrest the guy.
Okay, arrest the guy.
Be advised, sounds like we lost the guy in Chinatown. Keep looking.
Look at the town, it looks so ah! It looks so awesome. Top speed, top speed, top speed, top speed, top speed 100, top speed 100, top speed 100, top speed 100!
Tommy Angelo.
Lucas Bertoni. Oh, ain't she a thing of beauty?
We don't have much time.
Hey, I'm a fast worker. Sit tight. Hello, you.
Back before anyone catches on.
Go easy with her. She's gonna misbehave. Hey, tell Mr. Salieri I'm always available for this kind of work. I do stuff for a lot of people, but I always know where I stand with you guys. Hot cars, getaways, anything for the right price.
Let's just hope Salieri's guy wins tomorrow. For all our sakes.
Okay. Drive careful.
Cool. Here we go. So you only lose about 10 miles an hour. And you have to let it go down. Now it just sounds like a really cool car that's really slow. much smoother drive back. Crash right at the end.
Oh, you're back. Thank Christ. Good to go. Drives like a jalopy. Okay, let's get out of here. Big day tomorrow.
Big day tomorrow. Let's do it.
So Sam walks out of the bathroom, and I'm praying he's got a piece on him, because I'm not sure the bartender's going to hand over what he owes. And his two sons, they're inching closer. I can hear them cracking their knuckles. They're both 7 feet tall, built like brick shit houses.
What were you carrying?
My dick.
That's right. This crazy bastard, he waltzes out of the bathroom, just starts pissing all over the joint.
Really? What, he didn't call the cops?
Nah, sometimes you just gotta make them think you're crazy.
Tom, you got the moment?
Oh. Jeffrey.
We've got a bit of a situation.
Is the boss okay?
Oh, yeah, it's nothing like that. Mikey Dunn, our driver. Some of Morello's guys roughed him up pretty good last night. Broke his arm, broke his jaw. Send him to the hospital.
Jesus.
Yeah, tough luck for Mikey. Anyway, you're going to race for him.
Wait, what? Frank,
Tom,
I don't...
It's a half hour before the starting gun goes off, so this is not a discussion. But Don wants to win. But more importantly, he wants Morello to lose. And you are our best wheelman. Otherwise, I'd be talking to someone else.
Yeah. Okay, Frank.
Good. Rafi has the car gassed and ready. Get to the track right away.
Wally's awesome.
From Europe, we got the hotshot favorite, Martin Lichtenberg, taking some time out of the International Series to compete with us today. Got some news from the grid here. Lost Heaven local favorite, Mikey Dunn, is out. Replacing him is, Tommy Angelo. Well, I'm sure you'll all join me in wishing him good luck. They're lined up on the grid. They're ready to start.
Here we go, baby!
The pack pulls away, but there are some worried faces from the mechanics in the pit lane. Lichtenberg's in trouble. There's something up with his car.
Lichtenberg is out!
Son of a bitch!
A rough racing out there. Ooh. Hopefully nothing serious.
What the fuck? Did they mess our car up too? I thought this was going to be an easy race, for some reason. Am I still in the mix, though?
The race leader, Sloan, chances, or is it someone else's time to shine?
Where is everyone? Oh, we're so far away. Ah!
It's a tight pack as they fight for first.
We're literally never catching them. We're like a good 30 seconds behind. Restart the freaking race. What are we doing? Load last checkpoint. What are we doing here? Like 50 seconds behind them. There's no way we're catching. How do you go around those bends? There's not a drift button.
From Europe, we got the hotshot favorite.
What the... I didn't know that our car was just bad, though.
You're kidding me! What?
Aggressive driving from Angelo.
Ah!
Sorry, folks. We have doctors nearby if there's any injury.
All right, bro! Resume the last checkpoint.
They're lined up on the grid. They're ready to start.
Nice and easy on the bends here. Nice and easy on the bend. Oh, come on. Beat him on the straight here. You gotta beat him on the straight here. Come on!
Ah! Asshole!
Some rough racing.
Oh! Ah! I fucking hate this game. I'm gonna call the police. I'm calling the police. I'm calling Morello's police. I'm calling Salieri's police. I'm calling everyone.
Something up with his car.
All right.
Come
on.
Son of a bitch.
Are you kidding?
Or is it someone else's time to shine? Oh, my. That looks terrible. I hope they can walk away.
Son of a bitch.
All right. Come on. Here we go. I don't think we're catching up. Where are they even at? All right, this fucking Looney Tune ass car we're driving. Woo-hoo-hoo! What the fuck? What is what? I don't give a fuck about the hotshot favorite. Dinkle twins. Here we go!
What?
Oh! Come on!
Yeah!
Are you kidding me? I messed up.
Jesus!
I hate it! Like one of the worst driving sequences for me ever. And I mean, driving games aren't even that bad. I'm not even someone that's like, I hate driving games. This is just shitty. I literally don't get it. Like, random shit like that, especially when we started good, is crazy.
Him?
Yeah, there you go, guys. Fuck
Son
you.
Him? Son of a bitch!
Oh my god, we somehow got in first.
Are these the final podium places, or is it someone else's time?
Well, man, when you're in first, you can certainly fucking break and do everything all nice and gentle. Oh, look at this. 30 minutes. 30 minutes. Fuck this. I guarantee you this has to be the difficulty. Maybe it was relying on the difficulty. Although I feel like we got really fucking lucky. Nah, this is definitely the difficulty. We're gonna find out right now when they smoke us and catch up right here. Look at them catch up. Look at them catch up right here. Oh my god. Oh my god. Hey, this is such a wholesome, heartfelt story! When the cars aren't stupid! They're really not. They're really not jostling for position. Oh my god. Okay, come on.
Some drivers really starting to stretch out ahead now.
Yeah, some drivers is me. Oh, come on. Come on. God forbid, I freaking hope. Come on. Come on. Come on. Straight shot here. Terrible. terrible. Terrible race. Terrible race. Terrible part of the game. I hated every bit of it.
Hey, Tommy! There's our winner.
Hey, Tom. Just want to thank you for stepping in like you did. I had 6 months rent riding on that race. I'd be homeless now if not for you.
I just did what the Don asked, Lucas.
Well, you gotta let me find a way to repay you. Just stop by my garage when you get a chance. I might have a line on something that'll turn a buck for you.
Sure. Thanks.
I knew you wouldn't let us down, Tom. You made us all a lot of money today. And Morell's gonna be picking up pennies off the sidewalk for weeks.
Hey, what about the European?
He's probably wearing cement boots by now, the poor bastard. Here. You earned every dollar of this. Take your girl out somewhere nice.
Thanks, boss.
You got
a girl, right? I don't want you blowing all that on booze and whores.
Something, huh? Cheers.
Nah, but maybe I'll buy my mom a new coat.
Good boy. Go get yourself a drink.
Congratulations, big hero.
Nah, just got lucky's all.
Well, I had my money on the other guys, so drinks are on you.
Oh.
There. Now you're ready for the pictures.
Thanks.
And hey, when you're done celebrating, you might want to go find your buddy Polly. He's so drunk, he's gonna get hit by a parked car.
Car!
Yeah, okay. I'll get him home safe.
Polly and the rest of your pals have drunk through half my bar already. You found him yet?
That's all for another year, folks. Track will be open until 6. Please leave when requested.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, everybody. I fucking hated that shit. There is not one part of me that goes, you know, actually, that was a pretty cool little part of the game. I really like that they brought 1930s racing with all of its handling and horrific physics. Fuck that!
You're a natural wheel man, Tom.
I'm not! It took us literally fucking 40 minutes to do this, Vincenzo. We're ass!
Cannolis come that big.
Vincenzo, I'm dog shit, dude. Don't hype me up. I'm terrible. I'll see you later, Vincenzo. Don't make a bet on me again.
You mama made that look easy to Tommy.
I did not.
When they started racing here 20 years ago, most guys didn't even make the finish.
Ah, magic's in the motor, Ralph. I just showed him where to go. Hey, you seen Polly?
Oh, no. He said he was hungry or something.
Okay. You enjoy yourself.
Sure will, Tom. Thanks.
Okay. Hey, what up, man?
That win just put my daughter through another year at school, Tom.
Hey, anything for the Colettis.
Well, enjoy the moment. But the deal with Polly before he embarrasses himself and the family. I will not let the boss's day end sourly.
You don't have to worry, Frank. I'll find him.
All right, cool. Doesn't look like there's anybody over there.
I've been asked by the LHPD to remind all racegoers that the sale and consumption of alcohol is strictly prohibited. An arrest will be made. Thank you.
This your first time at the track?
Last year I heard the motors from my apartment, but that's as close as I've gotten before.
They'll start to try to clear us out before dark. But even more, the party won't stop.
How'd she drive after the tuna?
Tried to go sidelong at a 5-brick walls, but we made it. You seen Polly any place?
Came by 5 minutes ago, maybe. Looked like it had a smell from the barrel.
Sounds about right. Thanks, Lucas.
Great race, champ.
Hey! Last time I saw you drive like that, Tom, I had a gun to your head.
You saying there wasn't one today?
When our side of town is drowning in dough, that means you're safe. Hey, you seen Polly? Guy's soused.
Can't soused!
Walking sideways.
Yeah, I heard.
and refrain from imbibing illicit substances. Let's not make it like last year, folks.
Oh, thank Christ you're here. If your friend keeps this up, the other guy's gonna send the cops over.
Yeah, I think Polly's big day at the track's over.
Okay, talk to us. Wally, what's going on here?
Cow says moo, and the chicken says quack.
What
does the bird say?
I don't know, but the security guy back there says you gotta go home.
Guy's an asshole. You should show some respect.
Well, that's true, but I'm saying you gotta go home too, before you resurface the pit lane.
Well, okay then. I guess.
Let's go, Jim.
Oh my god. All right, get me back to regular cars again. Oh my god.
He did real good today, Tommy, with the driving. I was right. I was right when I found you. You know what I said?
What did you say, Polly?
I said this guy can drive, Don Salieri. This is a guy who can drive.
And here we are.
Here we are. Right here. That's where we are. You put me to shame, Tom. Look at you. Thank you.
You're trying to make me feel even worse.
What was I saying? What was I saying? You put me to shame, Tom. Look at you. Now you're even a... some kind of race car driver.
Well, you all got her.
You're doing real good since you joined the family, but you know you got it easy, right? Me and Sam, we keep the real stuff from you.
That right, huh?
You don't know what it's like. You get the call to see the Don and your mind's racing. Done some bad shit, Tom.
We're all in this together.
Copper?
I do what the Don asks when he asks it. Just like you.
You're like me, you can't just shut it down, blank it out like Sam does, go home to whoever the hell he goes home to.
Hey, Polly, you're drunk. You're gonna have to clam up for your own sakes.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. Tom, I wanna get with the lady.
I'm not helping you with that today.
Take me to the ladies! Take me to the Blue Tropics!
I don't know, I ought to take you home.
The bridge! Take the bridge over to the island! Take me to the ladies! Take me to those sweet patooties!
I don't know, taking you home seems more classy.
Alright, now we're talking. Oh boy. You should see these dames, Tom. Woo-hoo-hoo! Home? Brought me home? Maybe that's... yeah, a good idea. Yeah, well, okay, I'm gonna...
Sweet dreams, tough guy.
I'm gonna... I don't feel so good.
I... hated that. Oh my god. That was terrible. Sarah.
Hey, that's the cold, Tom. You want anything else?
Nah, I'm heading home.
Hey, Tom, before you go, I ask maybe a small favor.
Sure, Luigi, what do you need?
Welcome my daughter home.
Sarah? The way I hear it, she doesn't need any kind of escort.
she's a tough. This is a pack of boys that need her place. The punks, you know, cattivi ragazzi. They talk of blue, make advances. Sarah, she's gonna speak of the mind. But maybe she says a somber thing they don't like. Things that get ugly. But if you working at home, this is a reminder these punk she's the Don's a goddaughter.
No problem, Luigi. I'd be honored.
Benny. Sarah, time to close.
What's this then?
Tom's gonna take you.
All right.
Hey, I just work here.
Make sure nobody bother you.
Make sure nobody bother you.
Fine. If it'll make you feel better, Pop.
Hey.
I'll see you tomorrow. Let me get my coat.
I'll wait for you outside. You okay?
I don't need anyone walking me home.
Hey, we were talking about meeting up tonight anyway.
I guess.
And you can quit worrying about what he's gonna think.
Not the point, Tom. He treats me like a kid sometimes.
Hey, I get it. He's protective. He's seen things.
We've all seen things.
You know, we gotta talk about you stealing food.
Hey, I cook it, so I get to say where it goes.
Ollie won't thank you.
Well, maybe tomorrow's finally going to be the day he fixes his own breakfast. Could you knock on the doors? Only got so many hands here.
That for me?
Yeah, though it's not as much as last time.
It's enough. Nona thinks you're an angel.
The Don hates seeing food go to waste.
And this has gotta be Tammy. Sarah told us all about ya.
Is that right?
You're a famous race driver, Tam. Everyone talks about ya.
Yeah, she's right. They do.
Well, anyways, don't let the cold in, Juliet. I'll see you at church.
All right. Have a great evening.
Night.
Buena notte, Tommy.
Hey, Mama. Your angel Sarah brought more food.
It's nice you do that.
That? Well, a lot of hungry people on this block.
Yeah. Well... It's a good night for a walk, anyway.
Don't get yourself killed on my account, Tom.
I try to avoid it.
That's all you got? You spend all this time with a lady killer like Sam Trapani, and the best line you got is, good night for a walk anyways?
Well, it is, ain't it?
Oh, he's yeah, not the Rizzler.
I guess so.
Flowers for the lady, Signore?
Nah, we're good.
Now I don't get flowers?
When you let me take you on a real date and not some walk home for Luigi, then you get the flowers.
Yeah, that could happen. If Pop's not gonna stop me seeing one of yous, I think he knows anyway.
Luigi? Nah.
These guys have been creeps to me for weeks. But I didn't tell you as I know what you like. I mentioned it to Dad this one time, and all of a sudden he gets you to be my knight in shining armor. So yeah, he knows.
Huh. Well, like I say, means there's no problem with me.
If he did, you wouldn't last long. I know what happened to all the other guys I dated. I helped hide the bodies.
So now we are.
I've been trying to keep you safe, Tommy Angelo, all this time.
So let's go someplace. Tomorrow night, maybe. The pictures made me. You can get your flowers.
That'd be good.
Oh! Hey there, darling! Are you stepping out on us?
Piss off.
Don't cast the kitten doll face. We'll let your boyfriend watch. What do you say?
We going to have trouble here?
Trouble started back when you tried to steal our girl, Chief.
You saps aren't careful. You'll end up in wooden overcoats. Last chance to walk away.
We ain't frails. We know who you work for.
Salieri might have been the big six when he was younger, but he's all washed up now. Mm-hmm. It's only a matter of time before Morello punches his ticket.
I don't need Salieri. Or anyone else. Not for this.
Well, then let's see what you got, cake eater. Mm.
Where are you going, or sweet cheeks?
Back off!
Billy Shrey. You're some kind of dish, ain't ya?
Get away from me!
Twist my fuse twisted on that.
Smoked!
Let's see what you're alive, huh? You even touched me and you're dead!
You're wasting your time with getting like that. You need a real life.
I'm not the kind of dame you mess with, pal!
Get away!
Not at all!
Tommy!
Who the fuck's this guy?
My turn now.
Hope you're better than your friends.
Really? What is this garbage ass camera angle? Come on.
That's what I got, you son of a bitch.
Oh!
You got a good right hook. I'll give you that. You're bleeding. Come up to my place. I'll take a look.
Hi, Sandwich Angel. I just wanted to check out your other videos. Bye. Okay. Well, hi. And bye-bye.
Well, you gonna come in and take a load off or what?
I wonder when you'd invite me up.
The bank's closed, Slugger. I'm just gonna patch you up is all. Now go sit down on the couch, roll up your sleeve. I'm getting my sewing kit.
The bank's closed, Slugger.
Doesn't look too bad. You need something for the pain?
No, I'm fine.
You don't have to do that.
What?
I can see it fucking hurts, Tom. You want to pretend it? Don't go ask Polly to staple you up.
What do you get?
Compliments of the Don. Take another. All right. You gonna grin and bear this?
Yeah, I'll be okay.
Good. Because I don't need the little old lady next door complaining to the super about all the racket.
Just be quick about it, will ya?
Oh, it's gonna take as long as it takes. The sloppier the stitch, the uglier the scar.
That right. You stitched up a lot of fellas.
Just my father. Ma would really go after Luigi sometimes. He got pretty good at ducking dinner plates. So one day she stabbed him with her knitting needle. Right through the hand.
What for?
She's taking like 7 swigs, bro.
She was an ugly, jealous drunk. There. Not my best work, but it'll hold.
The scar will be something to remember you by, if nothing else.
You're staying over. Can't have you stumbling through the neighborhood pie-eyed. Not when them hoods are out looking for you anyways.
Yeah, okay. You got an extra blanket or something?
No. And the heat's out.
Aw. Good for you, Tommy Angelo.
DeSoto.
So Tommy Angelo is kind of the Rizzola. Okay. All right. We're going to save the game, and then we're going to probably go pop over and play like Tarkov for an hour or two. That helped calm me down. Good for Tommy Angelo. Love of his life.
Better get used to it.